Good day, everyone. I am Roy Benedict N. Babor. Today, I am going to talk about the important part of Philippine history, the Kartilya ng Katipunan. These are the three manifestos that played a significant role in the struggle of Philippine independence against Spanish colonization. I'll briefly introduce all three and then delve one of them and relate in our current situation. The first Kartilya, written by Emilio Jacinto, is all about a life that is not dedicated to a great and sacred cause is like a tree without a shade or a poison wed. Second, defend the oppressed and fight the oppressor. Third, a man's worth does not come from him being a king or in the height of his nose and the whiteness of his face, or in him being a priest, a representative of God, or in his exalted position on the face of this earth. Pure and truly noble is he who, though born in the forest and able to speak only his own tongue, behaves decently, is a true to his world, has dignity and honor, is not an oppressor, and does not abet oppressors, who know how to cherish and look after the land of his birth. Now, let's focus on the 13th Kartilya ng Katipunan. One aspect that I find particularly relevant to our current situation is the emphasis of the love for the motherland. In the 21st century, our nation faced various challenges from political issues to social and environmental concerns. It's crucial that as we Filipinos continue to uphold the principles of love for our country and strive for its betterment.